Whatever you want to do in life, there is a toolbox for that. Do you want to build a house or to repair something? There is this. Do you want to get more strategic knowledge and spend some time with your friends strategizing about war and peace? There is a box for that. Do you want to receive some knowledge about civilizations of the past? There is a toolbox for that, with maps, images and texts to drink tea. Well, there is a toolbox for that too. Do you want to
write a novel? Do you want to write a poem? Do you want to make a design? Do you want to make a film? Do you want to cast right people in that film? Do you want to
decide on what your next purchase will be? Do you want to decide who to be and not to be friends with? Do you want to know how to monetize your YouTube? Do you want to understand on which events to go and on which events not to go? Do you want to know where to move and where not to move? And for everything, there is a right toolbox. When you want to build a house, it's very important to pick a right toolbox and the right tools and the right materials. I don't have any tools. In fact, I'm now trying to construct a case for this balcony. But I have basic tools to repair things and to make them work again. It's this. Here I have this. I think that toolbox approach is very good at doing any tasks. We may think of any other objects as of toolboxes and to see how different features of them, how different opportunities they give us can unfold to be better understood and used. If we see a book, we may dissect it into certain elements, into certain structures, into certain tools. For example, tools like maps, illustrations, stories. That book really got very interesting. I just got a peek. It's a new book that I had from Book Crossing, and it's an interesting book about civilizations of Mexico. The real maps of pyramids. Wow. Even this small book is also like a toolbox. When I think about chess, and I like playing chess, I've been playing chess since childhood with my father, with my granddad, and now I also teach some people to properly play chess. Chess are also a toolbox in which we have many tools, many figures, which are tools to achieve certain results. One tool does not work as a standalone thing as well as a toolbox does. We may have this screwdriver, and we may do certain things with it, but of course the wider is the problem, the wider is a thing that we want to solve, the wider our toolbox needs to be. You may think about your computer or smartphone as your toolbox. You start a day with your computer and smartphone, but instead of it helping you, it often makes your life worse. It often is something that makes your life more dull and boring, because you start a day and you are scrolling for 30 minutes straight in the smartphone, as I was doing before, and it makes a day bad since the start. What if instead of that, you may pick right tools that will help you to do great things, to do beautiful things, both in your personal life and in your work creative life? I believe that those things cannot be found in digital space. I believe that most of apps, productivity apps, and note-taking apps, mindfulness apps, they try to find a solution to a problem which was created by those digital devices to that extent that we have now in those digital devices itself. What I believe is needed is a toolbox that is present in our real analog physical space that will help us to achieve our goals in all of our endeavors, both creative, personal, everyday. In my opinion, everyone can make this kind of toolbox for himself or herself. It's easy. You just pick correct tools, pick the right tools that you use day to day that help you from the start of the day to the end of the day. You combine them into a certain system. You can do it yourself. You may just now write out what practices do you use, from journaling, any certain methods of journaling, from some meditations and prayers, from some calendars, Kanbans, other systems, from talking to your relatives or friends, from taking a walk when you start a day, black tea instead of coffee in the morning, from going and buying good fruits and vegetables on the market instead of a supermarket or corner store, reading books at noon, for example. Those are habits and habit systems. On those habit systems, you may incorporate those systems and systems into this toolbox. A toolbox that you have, that you use every day. I made a toolbox for me, myself, maybe even 5 or 6 or 7 years ago. And only now I understood how it works. And now I try to capture its essence to make it better and to spread it with the world. My toolbox is based on handwriting. I have 5 basic forms on which I use handwriting in all of tasks I have. 3 core principles that I build my habits upon. And all of those are connected to create this physical operating system, this toolbox. I start every day with outlining my creative pursuits, my plans, certain things that I should do, certain decisions that I make, and it's all handwritten. And only handwriting helps me to make it very clear and understandable for me. It really becomes your second brain. It really enhances how you see the world. You may do a toolbox yourself from the practices that are close to you, that you like. But now I am trying to make this toolbox that I have available to more people, because I think that in today's day and age of digital technologies, when phones and computers are everywhere, it's important not to lose touch with our real world and to find solutions to our problems and needs in this physical world that we live in. And handwriting is much more free, much more structured and free, however you want, and it may be used to achieve anything. You may plan out your month, you may understand how to approach that exact person, you may understand how to do that creative task, you may conspect, you may learn, you may study, you may create, you may understand how to write better poetry, you may structure a film, you may design something, you may invent things, you may create beautiful things in your personal and professional life. A toolbox approach is exactly when you know that there are systems, small systems that function to achieve something, and you combine those small systems into something greater, into a toolbox where each tool is dissected. As in my system, I know that there is, for example, circle tool, timeline tool, mountain tool, map tool, and mind map tool. Those are 5 basic tools that my system has for now. It's like in this repair building toolbox where I know what are the tools, I know what I use them for, I know how each of them may be used to its best advantage, I know core principles. For me, those are 3 principles that I will unveil. And now I build prototypes. You see here, for example, is my first prototype. It's a giant box. I made it giant for purpose, because I wanted to understand how each part of it functions. What do I do with it? And I literally gone through various cities. I tried to implement it in my creative work. It was funny. It was very strange, unusual, and it given me a new perspective on toolboxes as a thing, on writing boxes, on the history of writing boxes and those toolboxes overall. Next, I've built a smaller box. It's there. I won't capture it now, but I will show it here. The second box is much smaller, much more practical, and I used it in public for a couple of weeks, but I understood that for a next step I need something else. So I returned to a usual notepad, and when I returned to this usual notepad, I understood how I do apply those principles and those elements, those tools in it, and why it works. So before developing a tool box, physical toolbox, that is another gadget, I need to figure out how it works as a system separately, how it works as something that may be done on any pen and paper. But now I have a couple of new ideas on how to implement it better in physical space, not just on a regular notebook, but how to enhance it. And in the next weeks and months, I will test it and test it with other people, and I will share results with you. That is all for this video. I hope you found some thoughts from it useful. This toolbox approach can be developed further. I think you may write interesting comments about it. It's always interesting to read. What thoughts do you have? If any thoughts, you may write anything on any topic. How do you use systems, tools, toolboxes, or if you disagree with me completely, you may also write it. I appreciate your support very much, and it really helps me on this journey of building an operating system and of overall living this curious and playful life. And I will see you in next videos. Subscribe for next stories, for next practical tips, for next subscribe for next videos, for next stories, and for next practical tips. And I will see you soon. So have a nice day or evening, and goodbye.